here. Welcome to our home. We're so happy you're here. I'm Laura Swayne, and this is my husband Steve. And we hope you have a great night.
God, we love you, and we're trying our best to love others because we know that's your heart. We are so excited tonight to play a small role in serving some folks who've had some really significant challenges in their life.
This is an incredible night tonight.
Amen.
We come out to celebrate survivors.
Amen.
We realize that all of us have survived something. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Come on, put your hands together for all the survivors in the room today. Come on, you can do better than that. All of our stories are different.
Amen.
All of our stories are different. We've all survived something. But one of the things that's so beautiful tonight is that through your struggle, you're being celebrated. You can't be free when you're battling with stuff that you carry.
Come on, Prince.
Tonight is the night of freedom. So we're gonna have our beloved sister, Sister Swayne, is gonna come and give you a greeting, and her husband's coming with her, Steve Swayne.
Do you know what a joy this is?
Amen.
Look, we are so happy you guys are here. Thank you for who you are and for being here with us. And
hey!
Yeah. We're just really glad that you're here. We are so proud of each of you for the survivors that you are. And we want you to know that you are very much like us. We are survivors too of different things. Our stories are all different, but we all are broken, and we're all so in need of the love of Jesus. So we're thankful to share that with you tonight. We're thankful to share good food with you. Lots of people have worked to prepare the food and just want you to enjoy it. After hearing Justin preach earlier in the summer about just the joy of having parties with people that we really don't know very well.
That's right.
And we don't do that often enough. So thank you for letting us do that. Steve heard that and was moved by it and said, hey, let's do this. And so all of the people that are here tonight, you know, with you that you didn't know before, wanted to be a part of that and wanted to get to know you, hope to be friends with you. So we celebrate you. And we celebrate the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
I'm just thankful you all are here.
Amen.
It is a blessing to have you all here. And we hope that tonight is a special night. And you tell us, it is a privilege to be with you all. So you just tell us what you need, and we will do our best to try to serve you as best as we can.
How great
is our God.
Yes.
Sing with me.
Come on, sing on with. Come on now.
Is our God.
Glory. Yeah. See me safe and through.
And think about why he despised the shame and made the first move. Like when someone's really interested in you and wanna be called your boo. But back to the cross and his divine love and the action for the lost. Stop.
I'm from the Raleigh Rescue Mission. I survived coming through those over 20 years. Being in the mission has helped me keep myself together, get back on track, so I can make a life for me and my girls.
I'm here because I had the courage to step out and start my own business a few years ago after a career in property management. For about 15 years, I've always had an entrepreneurial spirit. So I decided to follow my dream. And if anyone knows about business, they know that most businesses fail. And I failed. But some of my mentors have taught me that in order to be successful, you have to fail. You have to learn from
that's right. That's right.
10 years ago, I walked away from my faith. I was raped before leaving for college and went to a real dark place for that. But moved back to Raleigh, friends started taking me to church.
My story, what I've been dealing with, or what I am in the process of surviving, is the loss of my only daughter. My daughter was, she's the youngest of three. She was a senior at East Carolina University. She was 20 years old. And she was hit and killed by a young man who had a history of careless and reckless driving.
Those of us know we're broken, though we're sinful, that by your grace we've been healed, we've been set free, we have songs in our hearts that we can't wait to sing to you. God, you changed the world through meals like this. We pray you do it again tonight. As we gather and we share a meal with new friends and brothers and sisters, that you would use it to transform our pain.
Some of the things that we do, but you don't have to walk by yourself. I want you to understand, you don't have to walk by yourself. When I first got off of drugs, I thought I couldn't make it because I was sick in my body. I lost my home, I lost my family, and I just lost everything. Everybody knows what the devastation of drug addiction is. But I had some people to walk with. And the more they walk with me, the stronger I got. So I just want to pray strength in your life. I want to pray that God put the right people in your life.
Yes.
Because that's really important.
Yes.
Having the right people in your life. You want people to elevate you and encourage you instead of tearing you down or bringing you alongside of stuff that you don't need to do.
Yeah.
I pray that God bless you to make good choices. Because a lot of times it's also about good choices. And all of us have made bad choices in the past.
Amen. Yeah.
I believe somewhere down the line, the Lord is going to put us all back together again. Amen. One more time. That we can enjoy each other. Oh, can I tell you something? It won't cheat.
Come on now.
They didn't get, go to McDonald's and get you a burger.
Come on now. Bring, bring.
Sons and daughters of the Most High God being here. And we were truly treated with royalty today. Amen. So, my Father, I pray that you let your Holy Spirit fall fresh on us as we leave out of this place.
Yes.
We pray that you open doors that no man can close.
Come on now.
We pray that you bless with jobs. We pray that you bless with homes. We pray for restoration of family. We pray for the continued blessing and strength over addictions. And God, we just pray, God, the places where they go, that you dispatch your angels. And that they, you will grant them grace, you will grant them mercy, and grant them peace.
Yeah.
Again, we pray for Steve and Laura,
amen,
family. We pray your blessings over this home. We pray provisions abounding for their heart. And then we pray for Mormon Church.
Amen.
We thank you for Pastor Justin. We thank you for the church family. We pray a continued increase on that corner of Mormon.
Amen.
Now, Father, we just want to tell you how much we love you,
yes,
how much we appreciate you. And we know that all these things that have taken place is because of you.
It's all with you.
Now bless like you've never blessed before.
Yes.
May we be tied and bound to one another like never before.
Yes,
yes, it is my brother.
Yes,
yes, it is my sister.
Yes,
yes, when my brother takes a fall, we need to lift up.
Yes,
yes, when my sister takes a fall, we need to lift up.
Yes.
May we have that heart to lift up instead of stepping on folk and
hand them down.
Happens too many times.
Yes.
Now bless us as we travel from this place. We give you thanks, we give you praise, we give you glory, and we give you honor. It is in the magnificent name of Jesus Christ that we pray and thank you. Everybody, the sound of my voice.
Amen.
Hug somebody,
for grace, for... I need somebody to prophesy with your body language and say, what you say? God is leaning in my direction. Don't prophesy. I said he's leaning. In whose direction?